How to keep Windows running smoothly with routine maintenance. You do it for your car, it's time to do it for Windows. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Routine maintenance is one of those things that I mention from time to time, but so far I haven't really given you a good list of exactly what it is I mean. So in this video, what we're going to do is walk through that list and point you at the other articles and videos on Ask Leo that will take you each step of the way. Number one, I suggest you create a Windows recovery drive. That is something that you would use when Windows won't boot or you need to reset your password or any of a number of other things. It can even be used to reinstall Windows if it's created properly. The article, How to Create a Windows Recovery Drive, is where I would send you for all the details. Along those same lines, creating an emergency disk. This is a different disk. This is not created by Windows. This is created by your backup software. This is the disk that you would use when you decide you need to restore an image to your system disk. As you know, you can't write over the system if you're using the system. So what the emergency disk is a bootable copy of your backup software that you can then use to restore a complete system image to your primary drive. The article I'm pointing at, Creating an ESIS To Do Emergency Disk, will show you how to do that with ESIS To Do, but most other backup programs have something very, very similar, and I suggest that you make sure you've got that in place. Now, ongoing, one of the things that people should be doing, and honestly, it's very, very easy to overlook, is check those backups. Make sure that those backups are happening the way you think they are. I've had too many horror stories of people that have set up their backup, they've turned it on, and it works for a while, and then something goes wrong, but they never actually notice. So, one way to check your backups, of course, is to just take a look at the images, see if they're there and of a recent date. The article, How to Backup Windows, covers not just testing your backups, but also how to set things up in the first place. So that's a great place to start if you're interested in backing up. This is a little bit, I'll say, controversial, but the point here is that we definitely want to keep all of our software as up to date as possible. And yes, that includes Windows. I know you hear horror stories of people having a problem after they've taken a Windows update. Those problems are in the minority, and it's actually important that you keep Windows up to date so as to prevent any newly discovered vulnerabilities from being exploited because the update will fix those vulnerabilities. Now, I talk about Windows, but of course, this actually applies to almost all of the software that's on your machine. The only place that I typically don't recommend keeping things as up to date as possible is drivers. But for your applications, for other things that you're running on your system, if they've got automatic update, turn that on. If they don't, then make sure to check every once in a while, maybe once a month, every half year, something like that, depending on how you're using your system. Check your anti-malware tool. Very much like your backups, it's very easy to just sort of set it up, look at it once, and then assume that it's working properly forever after. Sometimes that doesn't happen. It's worth checking, maybe every half year or so, to make sure that your anti-malware tool is not just running, but that its database is also getting updated properly, and use that as an opportunity to perform a full scan of your system, rather than just the quick scan that's normally done every day. Another thing to consider? Uninstalling the software that you don't need. There is a lot of software we tend to install over time. We'll be trying things out or we'll use things for a while and we'll stop using them. The bottom line here, though, is that every such installation can actually add a little bit of something to your system to slow it down, to eat up disk space, to do any number of things. One of the ways to resolve that, of course, uninstall the stuff that you know you're not using. If you know you're using it, great, leave it alone. If it's not clear whether you're using it, well, start by leaving it alone and maybe do some research later. But I can guarantee that there are a list of things in the add remove programs that you really never use, don't want to use, and can safely remove. One of the places that impacts your system are, of course, startup programs. Startup programs are those programs that start every time you sign into Windows. Uninstalling software you don't use is one of the ways to get rid of some of that auto start software. But if it's software that you actually use, then it's time to take a look at what's being started automatically by that software and considering whether or not it really needs to. This is one of the ways that you can actually speed up your Windows startup fairly dramatically depending on what's happening. Some things need to run automatically, I get that, but every so often you'll find things in that startup list that can very safely be deleted. Cleaning your disks is something that I know people don't do very often at all. And this is one of those things that, again, it doesn't seem like a big problem until it is. It can impact performance. More often, it actually impacts the amount of space you have available to you on your machine. The article here is using disk cleanup in Windows 10. It applies to Windows 11 as well. And it talks about the disk cleanup tool that's included with Windows. Another approach is to use a tool called CCleaner that will actually not only clean up Windows files, but also some of the third-party files that Windows' own disk cleaner won't clean up. It's an interesting thing. I tend to recommend running both tools eventually. The Windows disk cleanup will clean up some things that CCleaner doesn't, and CCleaner will clean up some things that Windows doesn't. Together, you end up with a fairly clean machine. And finally on this list, yeah, don't forget the physical. This is one of those things where it's very easy to just leave your machine sitting and not realize that dust and dirt are accumulating both outside and inside the machine. This is a scenario where you periodically want to check to see if perhaps your machine has some of its ventilation ports obstructed, or even internally, there's too much dust or whatever, in my case, corgi hair, that's causing the air to not flow through the system properly so as to keep the machine cool. Now, that's the list of stuff that I would have you do periodically, once a month, once a week, once every 6 months, depending on how you use your system and what kind of impact these things are actually having on your experience. There are two things I want to mention that are things you don't need to do that are commonly included in these kind of maintenance lists. First, you do not need to defrag. As long as you're running Windows 7 or later, defragging is being handled for you automatically. The other thing that leads me to say don't defrag is, of course, SSDs don't defrag. You should not run defrag on an SSD. It'll shorten the life. And in fact, Windows, I believe, will prevent you from running an actual defrag on an SSD. There are other tools, other things that can improve the SSD's performance, but those are the things that Windows is also doing regularly in place of its weekly defrag of a traditional spinning platter hard disk. The other thing you don't need to do, and honestly, you've never needed to do this, but I suggest you don't do it, don't try, and that is clean the registry. There's really no reason to clean the registry. Sure, it can have lots of cruft left over from some of the things you've done in the past. It doesn't hurt anything. It does not impact your performance to any significant amount. This is one of those scenarios where, yes, if you're tracing down a specific problem, then sometimes, rarely, cleaning the registry can be a step in that diagnosis. But in terms of routine maintenance, no, you just don't. Now, to be clear, is everything I've talked about absolutely necessary? Of course not. Your machine will run well for a very long time, even if you ignore everything I've talked about. The point, though, is that if you do this fairly regularly, you will catch problems early, you will solve some issues that could impact your performance, you will clean up some disk space, and you'll just have an overall better experience. If you're watching this on YouTube, each of the articles that I've linked to in the companion article for this video also includes a companion video that will show you exactly what I'm talking about each step of the way. So, for those links to those companion videos, for those other articles, for comments, for updates, and more, visit askleo.com/165615. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com.